Yo, what is good, my anime freak? Well, what is good? Honestly, this sucked to see only because one of the characters I really did enjoy had to sacrifice it all for the group, and just knowing how much he's already gone through, it's pretty clear that this is the biggest accomplishment he feels he's achieved, and unfortunately, it cost him his life. So I really don't feel as if anything we've seen in this week's episode is to be taken fully yet, because I have faith that maybe Amon has survived, but maybe Guy, the AI, has sacrificed itself for him. I mean, he was pretty close to the explosion, and we've seen what type of stuff Ghost can already handle, not to mention the plot twist at the end, where it's like, oh, well, guess what? You thought it was over? It is not. So that's kind of the scary part as of right now, is just seeing what they're going to do with Ghost and how a character who didn't seem that evil, excuse me, is becoming the next biggest threat of the show, which is controversially easy to say once, like you actually have the idea of what kind of character he is, but to think that he was just going to do exactly as I called was kind of crazy. He waited out the battle. He has someone get eliminated out of said battle, so he doesn't have to worry about him anymore. And now here he is in a position where he is controlling the old AI of Ghost and having, that much more of a upper hand against any of the armies. Not to mention, it's Ghost, man. Like, bro, unless they learn every single thing about Ghost, you really think you can just control it? I mean, it makes sense that he thinks he can because of his ability to, like, control three robots at the same time while he was piloting and while he was manning another one. He was controlling two other robots. And some drones, I believe. So I get that he's already been in a position where he has controlled multiple, but you never controlled one like Ghost, okay? A AI that knew when to grab new robot material to fix itself. A robot who was in a battle and just shot out its wires onto multiple other robots and made them all shoot. It has practically the same thing as that dude who ends up getting Ghost's red indicator that it's still alive. So it's kind of clear to me that if he does have full-blown access and he's trying to use Ghost to its maximum potential, that just really means he's about to take it and do what it is it can already do. But for his people, which definitely sucks overall, because I thought he would be a better character, and clearly that is not the case because the common enemy is gone. Not only is the common enemy gone, it's an ally to him as he sees it. So we got a lot to worry about in the coming future of this show. I can't wait to see what this 8-month gap looks like next week. And for all the people who are saying it was supposed to only be 13 episodes, it looks like you were wrong. And with 8 months going by, I think that's just enough months for our main dude who already fixed up his robot once. I think that's enough for him to maybe fix it up yet again. So we'll see how that turns out. I definitely hope you all are having a good day, night, evening, whatever the case may be. I am your old boy, the Anime G, and I will definitely be talking to y'all sooner than later. So please do take care. Have an awesome one, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Please, oh, and like and subscribe if you've gotten this far. I have to ask these things because I guess it is the only real way to make your channel grow, is asking, because I have been sitting at the same number for a while sometimes, but I really don't care. I do care about my community having more people to talk to and stuff like that, so that's the only reason why I want likes and subscribes. So it'd be greatly appreciated. Thank you so much. Take care, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.